Hey, what's going on? Look, I wanted to drop some Boba Fett video. I mean, I wanted to drop some gameplay, and that's what I was gonna do. But the game out of nowhere messed around and dropped a triple double and an update too. So a triple double and an update. This is, I mean, before I get into that, this is good news. This just means that there's increased activity from the developers. They've added two new character heroes, villains, however you want to call them, plus two new variants of the turrets that can be used in the game. So I'm gonna just jump right to it. Right off the bat, we got Princess Leia. Now, I don't know how you feel about Leia. In the past, when I've kind of shown you guys some Leia skins, has gotten some pretty bad reviews, if any views. So apparently, well, this isn't relevant because if you don't have the game, I don't want to go over it. I'm more of just trying to show you guys the cosmetics of the game because when you download it, then you'll understand what it means to like boost and scans and how to obtain other cards. There are new planets now. I saw one of them today when I was playing a game. So they put new maps on here. Supply beacons. Again, that's part of acquiring minerals or gems, however you want to call them. But the new planet is Kamino. Looks like unlock for players to reach 2500 trophies. So you have to get to a certain tier to unlock it, which is weird. Why not just make the map available for everybody? It's not like it's an additional card that can only be used in a certain tier. So not a fan of that. So the other one is Captain Phasma, as I mentioned. Stormtrooper Captain of the First Order. Captain Phasma is a fierce warrior who uses her Quicksilver Baton to strike and knock back her enemies with devastating effect. Using her special ability, Captain Phasma can summon two First Order troopers to support her in battle. So I actually was facing Phasma. I didn't face Leia, but I faced Phasma. You can see in this video right here where Luke Skywalker just ends up wrecking her. Right before she's able to unlock her ability to drop two stormtroopers, Luke was not having it. So I went and took her out. But that I love that because that's effectively what we saw with Admiral Thrawn in Force Arena, where he would every I guess like every five shots. I wasn't a Thrawn user, so don't. I mean, you can correct me if you want, but I guess every five shots he would spawn two random troopers, which was nice. But yeah, that's the Phasma ability. Princess Leia is a formidable leader, commanding the respect and admiration of the Rebellion armies. Handy with the keep, all right. Handy with the keep. Handy with a pistol, she can more than hold her own on the battlefield when using her special ability. Leia's commanding presence inspires friendly troops to increase their movement and attack speed. So we got an attacking and speed buff. That is her ability. I'm trying to think, what was that in Force Arena? I'm drawing a blank here. Was it Kallus? Kallus's ally? I'm not sure. I think it was Kallus's ally or Kallus's unique. Was it Yist? I'm not sure. Anyways, but yeah, it's a speed and attack buff to all allied units around the Princess Leia Organa. And then I wanted to get into the new missile towers because these bad boys, I came across one and the dude was a savage when he used them against me. But briefly, all new missile towers have arrived in both light side and dark side flavors. Flavors, okay. These long range towers deliver a volley of four AoE area of effect, dealing missiles at regular intervals, whilst affected at dealing with enemies further up the battlefield. Man, they're making me read. I'm telling you guys, missile towers are vulnerable to close range attacks. So it's weak against Tusken Raiders and the probe droid, and for some reason this unit, BB, this evil BB unit. So when you saw in that video, the guy used it on my home base. So if you can overcome your opponent and just overwhelm them, rather, that's a better word. You can overwhelm your opponent. You can use that real estate to build your own turret if you have units that have surrounded and taken that territory, and it's to start shooting at your own home base. So that's troll level 101, and I hope that when I get my levels up, I don't get wrecked like that again. But yeah, I did want to go over that. But for the most part, this is good news, guys. This is good news because I can anticipate maybe by the end of the month this game being released. All right, don't hold me to it, but if they're releasing new characters now and they're new units, why not release the game? You know, you already have three characters. I think Force Arena started off with only two, but this game is starting off with three characters on each respective side. I would like them to see I would like them to drop the cost of these heroes because I think five is too much. Sometimes I don't even bring them out because it's too much, and it looks like they all have the same cost. So, you're not gonna see it like maybe, I don't know, an overpowered unit like Supreme Leader Snoke with like 8 energy cost because he deals way more AoE or things like that. But I was actually shocked because if you look at this, we have a bunch of clone units, like from the Clone War, Separatist units rather, and you would think that we would drop like maybe a Dooku or a Grievous. Oh my god, I'd love a Grievous. But we got Captain Phasma instead, which is not bad. It's pretty cool, but if you're going to drop a First Order unit, you got to give your boy Kylo some love. But hey, I'm not to argue here. We're definitely going to be getting more characters. I'm sure they're not going to just settle on these three. But anyways, I'm rambling at this point. Leia's fine, but again, I think that if they're going to go Clone War units like right here, then let's drop an Obi-Wan. You know, I'm quick to, because you know I'm a Obi-Wan homer. I'm biased as heck. So, of course, I'm going to say Obi-Wan over Anakin or any other, or Ahsoka too. But yeah, guys, just wanted to go ahead and go over that real quick. No gameplay, but I'm working on a Boba Fett video. And if I unlock Phasma or Leia, please believe that I'm going to be dropping gameplay on them next. So, thank you guys for watching again, and see you guys.